talk show, and we're here with important dignitary. You're gonna have to speak up, girl.
Hi, everybody. My name is Gladys, and I'm coming from you. Solid as a rock. Yes. PDX. Wow. We're serving the families of Portland and Alabama. It's a nonprofit organization.
Wow.
That my aunt has started here, and we're just giving our goods as we get them. Community.
Wow. That what inspired y'all? You just wanted to help.
Yeah, that's
wow. That's in your hand.
More giveaways to come. Go to our Facebook page called Solid as a Rock.
Okay.
And then you can get notifications for more giveaways.
More giveaways. I want to thank you all for coming out. I was at home and I said, let me go up in here and get them. I'm Jazz out from the shipyard just a bit, so we're gonna put it out there. I can come and do this. I got my grandson with me, but I say I'm coming to film you. Thank you so very much. And what? And y'all are giving out polo. Show me. Let's show them. I hope y'all can see it because we're in the shade. There go the polo shoes they're giving out. Jazz Red, we love you. Peace out. Wow, brand new, baby.
Thank you, Jazz. Thank you, Ms. Jazz.
All right, we had to come back because they're giving out phone cases, too. They're giving out phone cases with the bananas. Oh, look at that. They're giving out phone cases, too. Let's show what they look like. I want to show y'all what they look like. Oh, ain't that cute? Look at this here. Ain't that cute? Oh, that is cute. Girl, that's cute. They're giving out phone cases, too. What inspired you to come up here and help, ma'am? You up here?
I'm a member.
You into ministry?
Yeah.
Okay, women on a mission.
Yeah.
All right, they out here helping now. It's some volunteers. We'll get whoever want to say something. All right. What inspired you to come out here today?
Well, that's my mom.
That's your mom?
Yeah, that's my mom.
So you're following in the footsteps. Wow, coming out here. More kids don't want to do that. Bless you. Bless you. You shall be blessed.
Yeah, all right. I appreciate
that. See if I can get somebody else in. Jazz Red Talk Show, we got important dignitary here. What's your name?
Atia Harris.
Okay. What inspired you to come out?
Well, we brought it to our community because we like helping our people.
Wow. Wow. God bless you, sister. Yeah, it's hot out here, and they're out here giving this stuff away.
Going on with this virus and everything,
wow.
So we're doing whatever we can to help.
Wow, Jazz Red, peace out. All right. What's your name now, young man? Wow, you come out to help? Thank you. Representing this community. Jazz Red, we love you. Peace out. Jazz Red Talk Show, we up here at the food distribution. And outreach ministry, and we're at Spring Hill and Pine. We're gonna have someone, a spokesperson, to come and speak with them and tell them what you're doing. We're having a drive-by food giveaway. You know, Jazz would love to get people that are doing things, but Pastor Harry, Pete Martin, that go with Hoodman Billy, they've been doing this for a very, very long time. So we're gonna get a spokesperson. Jazz Red, peace out. All right, Keith, come on. Hey, Keith.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's get you before you get busy again.
What
do
you want me to say, Miss Harriet? Okay.
All right, come on up. And this is going to air Saturday, so you just explaining what you're doing because it'll come on after this.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to ask you your name first.
All right.
Got it. Jazz Red Talk Show, and I'm your host, Jazz Red. All right, we've got a young lady here that's going to be the spokesperson for this church. What's your name, ma'am?
My name is Sister Lakeisha.
Sister Lakeisha, what are y'all doing here today?
Well, we is an outreach ministry here at New Hope, located at 1007 Spring Hill Avenue.
Uh-huh.
What we do every other month, we give away groceries. It's like a pull-in drive-through groceries. You pull up, we load you up right here with our volunteers. You get fruits, you get dry canned goods, and you just come right on through. It's a kind, accurate service. You don't have to get out your car, you just come on through, and we give out groceries, water, and things of that nature to the community.
Okay, just to help out.
Yeah, just to help out.
Y'all been doing this a while, too.
We've been doing it a while. I mean, we've been doing this now for a couple of years now. What we do, sometimes we feed, pass our hot meals for the homeless, and we do a food pantry drive, and you know, it's sometimes perishable food items, meats and things of that nature. So you can look on Facebook, and actually we share a link on Facebook every a couple of days right before we do it, and it'll be the end of every month. And you can go on Facebook and follow my pastor Harriet P. Morton on Facebook. Okay. And you follow her, and she'll tell you every time we're actually giving out the groceries.
All right, do you know Pastor Morton, the church phone number, whatever?
The church phone number, Pastor Morton phone number is area code 251-925-8200.
Okay, do y'all take donations?
We take donations, whatever you can bring. We do clothing donations, we do monetary value donations, food donation, whatever you got to offer that may help someone else. That's what we take. You know, we're an outreach community. What we try to do is help whoever in need or whatever. Okay. So you can always come through and just drop it off. Or you can always call the pastor. Like I said, her number is 251-895-895.
What's the pastor phone number? Wait a minute. She coming back. You gonna do it all the way up to office.
Yeah,
we need her phone number. We need her phone number. Hold on a minute. We're gonna get the phone number.
479.
Let's start over.
Okay.
All right, what's the number?
442-79-05.
Okay.
And again, that number is 251-442-7905. And that's Pastor Harry Morton.
All right, the phone number is going across the screen, ladies and gentlemen. We're gonna show you a little of the scenery. Wait a minute. Come back here.
Okay.
What inspired you to come out in this sun? In this heat, and
well, you know what?
Why do you
I
do
can't
it?
Give, I can't give out money, so the only thing I can do is lend my time and help. And if you guys know anyone who want to come along and volunteer, we can always use your help because we always jam packed to the max. So if you want to just come out and volunteer your time and donate your time, that's a great asset. And again, we're located right across the street from the U-Haul place, right here next to the credit union. So you can come again at 1007 Spring Hill Avenue, come donate your time, and that's why I'm doing it.
Wow, that's why you're doing it. God bless you, sister.
Thank you.
All right, we're getting you a little of the scenery here. They're out loading up stuff. God is good. They're out putting it in there. You just come by and they put it in. All right, Jezreel, love you all. Anytime somebody's doing something good, just let me know. I try to get out to them. Jezreel, Outreach Ministries, Pastor Harry P. Martin. Billy Martin is a hoodman. Jezreel, we love you. Peace out. Jezreel Talk Show. It's been a while since I've been down here, but we're in Wing of Life. Wing of Life got a lot of nice stuff, old vintage pocketbooks. Oh, gee, that silver there. Girl, they got some stuff down here today. I hadn't been in a while. We got to get the pastor to tell y'all about the where I'm at here. It is so nice. Wow. Jezreel Talk Show, they got this bowl here. Come here, Reb, you got to tell them where you... Oh, okay, where your location at. He said he ain't able to talk right now. Jezreel Talk Show, we up in here. They got a lot of... I do not own the rights to that music. Yeah, I know that. I'm in here, and the music is up. They've got a lot of nice stuff. How you like that? They've got a lot of nice stuff. Y'all just got to come down. Jez hadn't been out and about a lot, but you got to come back and... Y'all gotta come check them out. Y'all see that's four of them glasses there. Wow. All right, they got a big screen TV down here. Wow. They got a big screen TV down here. Come check them out now. Want your kid to learn how to play organ? They got it. Yeah, I like that punch bowl. There's no need no more punch bowl. They got all kind of stuff. Speakers, everything. Electronics is over this way. Oh, there go a tripod. Let me check that out. Jezreel Talk Show. This is an antique sewing machine. I ain't got to tell you old schools about it. Y'all know what it is. Look at that, a light. That is real old. Got a light on the side. Jez got one of them. I don't know what year that is, but that's the light. That's the light. Girl, I've never seen a light on the side like that. Isn't that nice? And it probably works. Y'all need to come in here and check that out. Jezreel, we love you. Peace out. Y'all know they have a lot of shoes. Jez is just doing a little sweep because we'll come back. I'm just doing a little sweep for him. All kind of appliances. Girl, one lady left out of here with a basket. That's a good one. I had to quit. I had to shut it down. Y'all know they got a lot of shoes. Y'all just got to come down here and check them out. All kind of clothes. We're getting you a sweep of these shoes. They got a bunch of, they got them going on. Everything. Wow. Wow. Zooming in to them. I want y'all to check them out. They look like snakes to me. Desiree Talk Show, y'all know what those are. They got two of them, corn called. You put your cornbread in there. Wow, that's antique there. They got all kind of dishes. So many dishes. If you got a china piece or a piece that your grandmama had that you may have missed, you may can come and find it up in here. Wow. They got a lot of stuff. They got all kind of lamps. Any kind of lamp. I'm pulling my mask down. Anybody back here? Any kind of lamps. Woo! Baby, they got it. When I tell you, you got to come in here. It is so nice. This lady had a whole thing. I said, Lord, that lady. That's a girl. I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't do it, Lord. I got too much. But y'all young ladies, y'all just starting out. They got a lot of stuff. How you like that? That's a candle holder. And it hangs up in the air, that brown one there. Wow. All whatnots. Whatnots galore. For all holidays, duck season, whatever season. These are. I wanted to show you this dress. Size 3. Move the mask real. Size 3. Girl, look at the splits on it. It really is a cover. Top cover. Wow. Isn't that beautiful? Look at the back, y'all. Sheer. Sheer back. How you like that? Size 3, though. It's tiny. Very expensive, too. I'm talking about not in here, but somebody paid some money for it. Jazz Red, we love you. Peace out. Look at that. What was I filming? I wasn't filming nothing. Look at that. Jazz Redden got unprofessional. Let me go back to that chair. I'm gonna cut it if I ain't get this chair. I gotta get these chairs. Y'all have got to come get these chairs. Look at him. Jazz thought she was filming, baby. Y'all gotta come get these chairs. They're antique. They're antique. Y'all see them chairs? How you like that? Wow. They got a lot of stuff. Look at the little Benny. Oh, ain't he cute? Wow, they got a lot of stuff. Y'all just got to come out here. Y'all got to come out here. They got books, towels, blankets. Y'all know it's wintertime, but it's time to buy all your blankets.
Hey,
girl, you all right. Time to buy all your blankets and stuff. They got all kind of fun. Look, I want to show y'all this. Look at him. How y'all like that? How y'all like that? Hey, that's brand new there. How you like that? That's got to get back. Then they got another one in the back back there. How you like that? Jazz trying to zoom in too. Wow. How you like that? Wow. Y'all better come get these carryos now. Come get them. I'm putting you on it. Don't say Jazz say y'all got it and you ain't come get it. You better come get it. Isn't that beautiful? They got some, those are antique chairs there too. I know them chairs. I know them chairs very well. Come in here and just check them out. Boy, they look good. I'm going back on it, y'all. Y'all got to come get that. Y'all got to come get that. Jazz Red. Wings of Life. Phone number going across the screen. Peace out. Jazz Red Talk Show, and I'm your host, Jazz Red. You know, I always try to show you something antique every now and then. These are pill bottles that the lady, they're pill holders. The ladies would have their prescription years ago, and they would have these. Now, that silver one is probably the 70s, that purple 60s, and this one here probably back in the 40s. And it's a gold tone, and I'm going to show you how it look on the inside. Now, the gold one, that's how it looks. See, Traveler's Pill Caddy. Wow, a trip back in history from Jazz Red Talk Show. And her pill bottles. I don't want y'all on no pill. Jazz Red, we love you. Peace out.
And a good husband, and they told me that y'all watch me every week. It's your birthday. I wanted to come out and say happy birthday.
Thank you, man.
What is your name?
Thomas Kent.
Okay, Mr. Thomas
Kent.
Your family love you. Your daughter called me. What's your daughter's name?
I got several.
What's your name? Michelle called me and told me to come out and put her father on my show, and I wanted to do that. They watch me every week.
Yes, that's right. I've been watching my wife. She just breaks the television down. So I get to it.
Thank you. families and friends and nieces and snows. Everybody in the community that loves you. Happy birthday, may not be a minute before. Last time you get a man shake a leg one time, Tom. Come on, shake a leg one time, Tom. You're running off with that Mardi Gras. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you.
everyone into the sea of forgetfulness. You placed all of my sins. Now I'm the one who keeps reminding you over and over again into the sea of forgetfulness. As far
another verse, now listen. It could have been me, locked up in jail, y'all. It could have been me, with no one to go my bail. It could have been me, I know it could have. Strung out on crack cocaine, y'all. It could as well been me, shooting heroin in my mind. And I stopped by to let you know, 'cause it could have been me. I had a witness. Oh, I thank the Lord, yeah, yeah. 'Cause it could have been me. Every time I go down on my knees, I have to say thank you. 'Cause it could have been me. I got one more verse, now listen. When the doctor shook his head, can I get me a witness? It could have been me, sleeping in my grave. But Jesus stepped right in, y'all, and he made old death behave. And I come to let you know, 'cause it could have been me. Oh, I thank the Lord for saving me. He didn't have to do it, but I'm glad about it. Oh, I thank the Lord, yeah, yeah. 'Cause it could have been me. Every time I go down on my knees, I have to tell somebody. Time I go in the room and fold my arm. Here's what I say.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, I thank you right now. Have anybody ever took the time out?
Thank you, Jesus.
To say, Lord, I thank you. 'Cause you've been good to me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, you've been so good to me. When I don't have no money in my pocket, I don't let it bother me, because the Lord said he'll work it out for me. I knew he will. Have anybody been lonely tonight? The Lord said he'll be a company keeper for you in a lonely hour.
Been shipped to the south, sleeping in rice fields, orders from the White House. But there's only one thing I wanna know. Ooh. Somebody tell me, where did peace go? For 10 long years, we've been fighting the money war. The poor boy's been dying, tell me what for. Now there's only one thing I wanna know. Somebody tell me, where did peace go? I have died in vain. Leaving their family misery and pain. But there's only one thing I wanna know. Somebody tell me, where did peace go?
This is a funeral for everyone who has been killed. All who have fallen and died. We're here at the Rayshard Brooks Memorial.
Jones. There you go, Miss Jones. There you go, Miss Jones. These are all. Here's Freddie Gray from Baltimore, Maryland. Freddie Gray. Everyone has been represented. Ahmaud Arbery. Everyone has been represented. This is a funeral for all who have fallen. And we are at the Rayshard Brooks Memorial in Atlanta, Georgia. This is why we're here, to stop this. We're here to stop this. This is why we're here. We're here to stop this. We're here to end this. We're here to end senseless tragedy. We're here to end suffering. We're here to end pain. We're here to end this. We're here to end a deliberate attack on the black community. This is why we're here. Thank you, baby. Thank you, baby. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. This is why we're here. We're here to end this. We're here to end this. I've never seen anything like this before in my life. We are here to end this. This is why we are here. This is why we are all grieving right now. We're constantly grieving. Everybody in the black community has post-traumatic stress disorder because we look every day and we see someone else, one of our children, one of our sons, our fathers, our mothers, slain in the street. We are all in mourning and we're here to stop this. We're here to end this. We must work together. Work together. Love one another. Keep the focus. We're here to take care of business. This is not a party. This is not a game. This is not a club. We are here to take care of business. We are here to make sure that each one of these lives were not taken in vain. It will not happen in vain. Each one of these lives means something to me. And if your people are not represented here, if your people are not represented here, know that we haven't forgotten them. If your people have died senselessly in our community, please put their name on this Facebook page right now. Please add their name so we won't forget them too. Add their name so we won't forget them too. We ain't forgetting nobody. Nobody. We ain't forgetting nobody. This is Atlanta, Georgia. This is the cradle of the civil rights movement. This is the cradle of the civil rights movement. And we are only in phase 5 of the civil rights movement. Put your name up so we won't forget your kinfolk too. We want to know if there is a name missing here today that we need to observe. Please let us know. Let us know now. If there is a name that we have forgotten right now, let us know. Miss Katherine Johnson. Miss Katherine Johnson was killed on Neal Street. Miss Katherine Johnson was in her house minding her own business. And these willy-nilly, no good cops kicked in her door. And she did what my grandmama would have done, what my mama would have done. She had the right to shoot back. And they shot and killed her in her home, and it was a mistake. Then they tried to plant drugs in her house. Then they tried to plant drugs in her house and say that it, and try to make it seem like it was a dope trap. And they all went to jail. And this is when we started the Citizens Review Board. Now we getting ready to bring more transparency to the police. We getting ready to bring more transparency because it did not stop with Miss Katherine Johnson. It continued on. It continued on. And that's why we are here. We are here to end this. I will never forget Miss Katherine Johnson. And this is Rayshawn, the latest. The latest. This is why we're here.
How you been doing? It's so good to see you. Yes.
Remember what you see today. Let this be the last time we do this. Remember what you see today. Remember, feel it, understand it. We are not out here for a party. We are out here to take care of this business. Every one of these people have lives. Every last one of them have a place to be. They got priorities in their life. They are out here in a virus, risking their lives to get justice for the black community. They have seen this too long. They killed our babies in the Atlanta child murders. That's the first time I saw murders of our children in Atlanta.
That's right.
That's the first time I saw it. I lived through it. Two of my students, two of my classmates lived on Ontario. They found their bodies. This has been happening in Atlanta for far too long. Far too long.
Loading up. Okay. Please,
crime.
Much.
There's so many people.
You guys stay positive. We can just jump on. You guys stay real positive.
Thank you.
Lisa, get on that side.
Have a blessed day, everybody. Have a blessed day. We gonna stay out here. Stay with us. Vote. Vote the people out of office right now that are going against the hate bill legislation. The hate crime legislation, if they're going against it, we need them out of office because they're being inhumane. They're being inhumane.
Ourselves. We're tired of beating our head against the wall and working with